For the first time in their history, the St. Louis Blues are the Stanley Cup champions.
Welcome to another episode of Inside the Note, presented by the Mid America Chevy Dealers. And one of the biggest stories this week is that the great Doc Emrick has announced his retirement after calling more than 3,700 professional and Olympic hockey games. So let's start things off by paying tribute to him and looking back at some of our favorite moments.
Hello everyone, I'm Mike Emrick from 1401 Clark Street in St. Louis. I'm back to Busch Stadium.
Big hit by Lowry. Hucks that back off in Janney. Put one in front! Score! An emotional end. Since 87, when the first round became best of seven, only two division champions have been swept four straight in the first round. A sweep for the Blues.
Now Hull.
Well, the new one is aluminum, isn't it?
Yes,
Hull
it
over
is.
To Duchesne. Hull! Score!
Twenty-fifth, 26th, and 27th of the year in the span of almost 11 minutes.
Stastny nicely able to pull away. Got it to Fabry, side of the net. Save, rebound, score! Brower!
Tara got it to Tarasenko. Shooting, he scores! Tarasenko again! It's their first one, and they made it a lasting memory for sure. Came back along to Gunnarsson once more. They've got Sundqvist set up at the opposite circle. Across to Gunnarsson, a shot, he scores! The Blues win it in overtime and have evened the series. And the Blues at the bench are realizing that they are going to be champions. 10 seconds to go. The longest wait for a first title any team in this league has had. For the first time in their history, the St. Louis Blues are the Stanley Cup champions.
Thanks to Doc for all of the incredible memories. There's no doubt Blues fans will never forget the sound of his voice whenever the team won the Stanley Cup for the first time in franchise history. Blues broadcaster Chris Kerber also had an iconic call of that special moment. But what you might not know is what the voice of the Blues struggled with during this past playoff run.
Well, I'm here with my broadcast partner, Kerbs, and Kerbs, I know it was going to rain a lot this week, but I didn't think you needed a life vest for this interview.
I'm telling you something, and I mean this, and you know me, because I'll rip on myself more than anybody. Okay, whenever you wear a vest, jacket, or whatever they call these things, if somebody doesn't crack a Marty McFly flood joke, shame on them.
No, Kerbs, I want to talk to you about something more specific today. Hearing you talk right there, you sound really good. And I was a little nervous about how you'd sound, and why don't you enlighten the fans why they've been seeing a lot of me and less of you. They probably won't be seeing more of you, but they've been
that's
seeing a lot of me.
No, that's okay.
Where
that's
has okay. Chris Kerber gone? Will you explain what's going on?
Over the last, who knows really how long, I'd be talking, and then after doing a game, my voice would just be shot for a while. So they found a polyp on a vocal cord, and so I had to have surgery to have it removed. So I did that on, I think it was September 21st, that Monday, right around there. So right about now, we're in week five or so of kind of coming out of that. And this is the first week, as you and I are recording this, this is the first week where I'm actually able to test some levels. Like the healing is to the point now where I can really get loud. Now this
there.
This should scare you. Okay, so I asked Dr. Joseph Bradley, over at BJH, did the surgery, did a fantastic job, said it went like picture perfect. If he could take the video and use it to teach students, he would. And so that's good news that it went that well. Said it was a pretty really large polyp. And so through that, afterwards, when I was finally able to go see him, I couldn't speak, didn't talk for basically 9 days. I said, well, what can I expect now? And he says, well, it's going to be a lot easier for you to get the sound out because there's nothing blocking the air and the way that the vocal cord should work. And I thought, whoa, there's another level.
Yeah. was there a lot of anxiety and stress leading up to the surgery? Is this even going to help? Is it going to make it worse? I mean, this is, your voice is pretty much your life.
Not a lot of stress or anxiety. So when the doctors talk to you and then they've got to tell you, you know, like it's rare, but you know, there is a chance something could get nicked and you could end up with a hoarse voice. And they've got to tell you that. And then that's not what you want to hear when your voice is what you do for a living. So Outside of that, no, it was more like, look, you got to get it done.
Yeah.
If something happens, something happens. We'll take that as it comes. But
so you used a whiteboard.
So I had a whiteboard.
Took it around everywhere.
Only once or twice did I end up having to write a paragraph. I probably slipped up once a day, and the kids would jump on me. Like, we picked up dinner one night. It didn't look like it was everything in there. And just naturally, and this is probably about a week in, I kind of looked. I looked at Gracie, and I went, is it all there? I went, ooh. And I hadn't even, you know, you hadn't heard your own voice in a while.
Right, right.
Or a couple times, something would happen. I go, ooh.
I miss you.
It was a good talk.
It's good talk. It's good catching up.
Great to see Curbs back and healthy. And more good news, as it was announced that Enterprise Center will host the 2025 NCAA Men's Frozen Four Championship. Now, this is the first time this event has been in St. Louis since 2007, but the Blues have been trying to land this for quite some time. And now, thanks to the incredible renovations to the building, as well as the development of the Centene Community Ice Center, this will be huge, not only for the city of St. Louis, but also to continue growing the sport here in the heartland of hockey. And also continuing to put St. Louis on the map in the sports world is the world's most famous team dog, Barclay. So let's take a look at his next step in his journey to make a big difference.
So today's the big day where Bark returns to Duo to come in for his advanced training and his journey to become an assistance dog.
Advanced training is really going over what they've learned in basic obedience, and then depending on where they think he might go, learning specific skills. So a pull, which could open a refrigerator door, or a retrieve, which would pick up something as small as the back of an earring. So learning these skills that could help an individual lead a more independent life. If he's working in a hospital, he's going to be used for therapeutic purposes.
I'm extremely proud of Barclay, and he's really brought a community together. We've found fans that might not have been hockey fans or Blues fans in the past, but because of their love for animals, they started following the Blues, and knowing that we had a small part of the raising him, and it's gonna mean so much to give back to the city of St. Louis.
Being a puppy raiser is very selfless. These people take the dogs into their home, so they took Barclay into their home, they fed Barclay, they took care of medical expenses for Barclay. They love Barclay, and they gave him basic obedience. And now he's gonna serve a bigger purpose.
Things certainly won't be the same around the Blues offices with Barclay off at training. And this Halloween season won't look quite the same either. But as we take a look back at some of our favorite costumes and memories from Halloween's past, don't worry, this year will still be special. In fact, the Blues will be participating in the Friends of Kids with Cancer drive-through Halloween party on Saturday, October 24th. The Blues are also hosting a costume contest, so be sure to send us your submissions with the hashtag BluesHockeyHalloween for the chance to win a visit from Louie on Halloween morning. Something else to participate in is the virtual Blue Note 5K. And check this out, right now we have runners all across the country, so let's keep this thing going and try to get runners from every state. Of course, if you are here in Missouri, we still want you to sign up as well, so head over to stlouisblues.com. That'll do it for this episode of Inside the Note, presented by the Mid America Chevy Dealers. Thanks for tuning in.